You're doing all right. Excellent. Good.
Who's not seeing
us? We're at the same place.
No.
All right. All right.
We're going to get that film ready for the evening news, I wonder. Do you know there's nothing that you can't want to see that's not on YouTube?
Yeah.
Or a film of some sort on somewhere. If you want to learn how to do anything, you only got to go on there and there's a film on it.
Yeah.
Turned into a bit of a one-sided beat, isn't it?
I think that little illusion when it's windy is pretty good. But when there's not much wind, it's quite slow. Like any boat really, but I think it's particularly with that one.
Well, I heard a programme on the radio with Robin Knox Johnson.
Oh.
He was he's organised a programme of teaching people to sail around the world.
Okay.
So they'll do like do his friend of course, then do a section.
Okay.
I'm not saying before.
Yeah.
And he was saying any fool can sail in strong winds, but it's a real skill to sail in.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
Just got back a little while ago from our holiday. We went on a cruise around the Caribbean.
Oh wow!
And the sea there is like this.
Is it really?
There's hardly a ripple on it.
Yeah, but much clearer.
Yeah, very, very clear. First time I'd been there, and it was really, really nice.
Oh really? I've never been there. No.
Yeah, I've never had before.
Oh great! Yeah, nice in the Mediterranean. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, it was lovely, delightful.
Very good.
I mean, the Mediterranean's got it's much more sophisticated. Mm. Caribbean's a bit, backwards, there's not all the facilities, but very, very nice climate, nice sea, nice everything. Mm. Yeah, all the natural stuff's good.
Sure. Oh, very nice. That was on a cruise, was it?
That was on a cruise.
Which boat was
that? Now you're asking.
Was it Carnival Cruises or was it?
The company, it was P&O.
P&O, very good.
Which is owned by a big American company.
Oh.
I can't remember their name. Mm. I think this company owns about half a dozen big cruise organisations. We flew it out to Barbados, picked a boat up there, and then sailed around about 9 islands.
Great.
For 2 weeks.
Wonderful.
And it was, you couldn't fault it.
No.
I'd never really fancied it before. I thought it would be a bit restrictive.
Who did you fly into Barbados with? Which airline?
I think it was Thomas Cook.
Oh, they're very good, yeah. So it was all part of the thing.
It was all in one arrangement.
Yeah.
And it was a brilliant plane. Nice big plane.
Yeah, one of the nicest flights I've ever been on was a Thomas Cook flight from Birmingham to Toronto, actually.
Yeah.
It was a really, really nice flight. It was just, everything about it was good.
Yeah.
They're very good, actually, yeah. So it was a Thomas Cook holiday, was it?
No, we booked up direct with P&O.
Oh, okay.
And they just sublet the flight to
Thomas Cook.
Oh, I
see, right, yeah. Very good.
Yeah, so it whetted our appetite to do it again.
Yeah, great, yeah. Excellent.
Yeah, the weather here is pretty miserable, isn't it, after Christmas, January, February, so it's nice to get away.
Yeah. UK's good for learning things, whether it's flying or sailing. It's quite good because it's very challenging.
Mm.
It's challenging for flying because we've got such restricted airspace, and it's challenging for sailing. Because we've got the terrible weather, and somewhere like this, you can sail here, you can sail kind of anywhere, because the wind here won't be the same as the wind over there, and then the conditions can change all of a sudden.
Yeah.
So, and of course we've got tides, and we've got tides here, so we've got tides in the UK. But you wouldn't want to actually do anything for fun in the UK. Again, whether it's flying or sailing, why would anyone fly or sail around, unless you're flying around Scotland or something. Why would you fly as that in the UK when you can go to much nicer places like Germany to fly or Mediterranean to sail? That's my view. Right. Yeah, great. But it's good for learning things here.
Yeah.
And the qualifications here are recognised everywhere, which is great.
That's true.
I remember years ago with NBC had a program called Seinfeld. Do you remember that? It was an American comedy. Your daughter and I were about it, and it's the funny thing about Seinfeld, it was a very risky comedy for NBC to commission, because it wasn't the classic kind of style of sitcom. It was a very risky format where you had a lot of kind of characters fulfilling stereotypes, it was very clever what they did. They took a big risk with it, which paid off. And the guy who wrote it, someone called Larry David, who's quite a famous comedian in America, he's quite a famous writer. But NBC is a very, very good risk with that. It's very, very forward-looking.
Yeah.
It's called Seinfeld.
We've got one of their comedians gone over there to do one of their TV
shows. That's right, yeah. James somebody,
isn't it? That's James...
Gordon.
Yeah.
I've never heard of him before.
He's a sort of stocky guy.
Yeah.
He did a TV program on here that I watched a bit of, and I couldn't get the hang of it at all. It just went over my head completely.
Oh, we did it, yeah.
Recently.
Mm.
But I've seen him in things. He's been very funny.
Oh, is he? Yeah. And is that NBC as well?
I don't know what channel it is. I know he's more of a channel, so nobody knows him.
In America.
Every 5 minutes you say, "Oh, you don't know me."
Yeah.
Because
nobody does. That's like Jimmy James, isn't it? No one knew he was a footballer in America.
Yeah.
They'd know him. They didn't.
They've done a few films.
Yeah, that's right. And they didn't care, did they?
Oh, Saka! Yeah.
battery to the back as he does. Race. I'm rubbish at things like this. Fixing things.
Thank you. my parents live in Epping.
Whereabouts in Epping are they?
Hemel
Street. Yeah, I live in Epping.
Yeah.
Just off Finsbury Street.
Oh,
you know, by the war memorial?
Yes.
Turn left there, Lindsay Street, and we're first proper road on the right.
Oh, okay, I know.
Road of Bungalow, Lindsay Grange.
Oh,
very nice. Right there, that's where the sports centre is.
What's going on in the sports centre?
No, we weren't living in Epping when she was in school. She went to a school in Downton.
Thank you.
All of a sudden, everybody's winning.